Let's see. Okay, here this was interesting. This guy asked, why do girls stay friends with their exes, and how do you deal with it? Okay. Mm. Now, there's two real, which is a really good question. Okay. Mm. Now, if you're the ex, right?
As the man?
Yeah, as the man.
Well, you're staying in case
you're the,
you
the guy, and you're right. Keeping in contact with a guy. All this dude is not. You do not have a male friend. I say this on stage. But women who think that they have a male friend, you don't have a male friend. You have a guy that's waiting to fuck you.
Yeah.
And if he's not the one that broke up with you, right, he's still just lingering around hoping that he gets an opportunity to fuck you. Mm. Now, if you're that guy, you will never get that opportunity because she's already made her decision about you.
Yeah. She's already – once a woman – this is a weird thing. As much as women get obsessed with you – once they decide they're
not
done with you,
obsessed.
Holy shit.
They don't give a fuck about you.
Because they also do have that ability to rewrite history.
Oh, yeah.
And that fucking movie, you are a fucking villain on the way out
you
that door.
You are homeless by the time she's finished with you. And she didn't give you a quarter when she walked by.
Right.
But what can happen is if you give it some time and if there's a catastrophic event, right, then you can... She might take another look. It was interesting. I talk about my sisters all the time. My older sister, she.
How many sisters do you have?
I have four sisters.
Oh, that's ironic.
I have four sisters.
So ironic.
And that's kind of watching them. I'm the baby, so I watched this. I learned all the crazy shit that they were. And my older sister, she, it was a guy who liked her.
Right.
Chubby dude. Right. Good looking guy, but he was chubby. Mm. And then he went and he. Chased her down. He liked her, and she had no game for him, right? So he goes away to the Peace Corps for a year, right? Ain't no food in the Peace Corps.
Yeah. He's gonna come back and shave.
Ain't no food in the Peace Corps. Yeah. So he comes back, and his jaw is chiseled. He got gray eyes, sandy brown hair, black dude, right? Good looking dude, six pack. He's carrying water and digging ditches and stuff. And he came back and I was like, oh, like, now this, he hung around her as a chubby dude his whole life, ultimately married my sister's first marriage.
Right.
That was, his first marriage was, but there was this catastrophic event that he went away, the dust settled, and then boom, when he
came
back.
Sometimes you gotta rebuild that character.
Sure.
Sometimes you gotta step away, you can't do it.
And he was a chubby dude who didn't have the confidence, and when he came back and he had the six pack and on,
all of a sudden he had some confidence.
He had a little Jason Cross glazing on him. He had a little, a little swagger.
But he was in the Peace Corps, so he was a decent human being.
He wasn't just... So
fingering broads at the back of the Boston.
And a year later they were married.
Right.
So, you get that situation. But what's interesting is a guy could be with a girl and treat her like garbage, and then in his thought process, later on he goes, man, that was the one that got away. And he'll go back and look this chick, man, she was such a sweetie. And man, I really fucked that up. And then if he gets another opportunity, he'll push his mentality about this chick could change. Like we, because we look at it logically, but she's clearly she's a different person. She's clearly a different person. You know what I'm saying? Altogether. So it's really an interesting concept of how we will change our opinion, but they won't. So what he's asking is why do girls stay friends with their exes? Is what they're really is they're pimping the game, because ultimately what they're doing is they get the benefit of the companionship,
right,
without having to give up the sex. So they'll keep you in friend mode. I mean, what also means he's talking about is the friend mode.
Yeah.
Right? So if you're in the friend mode, they get all of the things that they want and give up none of the things that they have to give up.
Right. And that they don't have to go through the awkwardness of the fight stuff. They get to leave clean.
And then they treat you like shit and you put up with it.
And by the way, that usually, I find that usually happens when the chick moves on with someone else.
Yes.
It's rare that she breaks up with you. And also they never break up with you without having
something. If you're breaking up with her, she's either pursuing you or she's dumping you and don't ever want to see you again. Because she cares about what she thinks. She don't care. She don't give a fuck about what you think and how you feel. Now, if you're the guy who is with the girl who still stays with friends with the ex, I don't really think it should be something that you should be worried about, because even if he's cutting your throat, all he does is make you look better anyway. Because if he's, you shouldn't be with him, you shouldn't this, you shouldn't do that, all that does is make you more attractive to her anyway. So I don't think you should worry about it. But if you decide that you don't want to do it, you don't want to do it again.
Just leave.
Take the L. You always can take your ball and go home. So if he's like, listen, I get that this is your friend, and I totally get that you need him in your life. But you know what? If you want to have him in your life, you either want to have him in your life. You know what? In fact, I'm not even going to let you make a decision. I'm going to just pull my – I'm going to not be here.
So I'm removing myself from the negotiation.
Exactly. That is the best negotiation.
Right.
Don't go, if you do this, I will do that. It's a problem.
No, I'm leaving. I got to go.
I'm out. So, I mean, and that negotiation is where you're not getting high on your own supply. You're in a situation where you're making the decision based on the decision that you can make. You know what I mean? As opposed to where you're making a decision about something that you really can't control.